What's going on, folks? It's a very long day today. Didn't really get to do a lot of labs or studying that I anticipated, but it is what it is. Before I go to bed for the night, I at least want to get one lab done. So this is going to be the MPLS L3 VPN VPN V4 route reflection with iOS XR. The last video I did it the one with the route reflection on iOS XE. So we're just going to see how that works on this configuration with iOS XR. The diagram that we're going to be working with is the multi-site L3 VPN diagram, which is this one here. So I pre-configured, I already got the routers pre-configured with the startup configs. So now we just can dump right into the task. Make this pretty quick. Alright, so on router 2 and 5, we need to configure VPN A with route distinguisher and route target 101. On R4 and XR1, you got to do the same thing for VPN B with VRF 102. What mean with route distinguisher and route targets 102? Make sure that the links are signed to the correct VRFs. That's what the last step of each VPN config is saying. Configure EIGRP AS1 on the links between the PE and CE and advertise the CE's loopback 0 networks in the EIGRP. Sounds pretty simple enough. And we're going to configure BGP on router 2, 4, 5, and XR1, which is our PE routers. And we're going to use AS100. All devices should peer with XR1 via IBGP VPN V4, which means that XR1 is going to be the route reflector for the network. And XR1 should be the VPN route reflector, as it says here. Use the loopback addresses for the sources and redistribute between the VRF-aware EIGRP processes and BGP. So once complete, we're going to verify reachability. So sounds pretty straightforward. Let's jump right into the config. So on the first one, we're going to go ahead and do the VRF configuration on router 2 and 5. So let's pull up our diagram here. So on router 2 and 5, we are going to be configuring VPN A. So let's log in to. So we'll just do it on 2 first. On VRF definition, VPN A, route distinguisher 100.01, and then route target both 100.01, and then we activate the address family IPv4 unicast, activate that. Protection VRF. So we'll take this and we're going to copy this on the router 5. And then on R4 and XR1, we got to do VPN B, so we can just switch this around for VPN B for at least R4. So 2, 2, 2, good to go, and we'll put that on router 4. And so what I just did is on router 4, 5, and 2, I created the VPN VRFs, and let's go ahead and do it on XR1 as well, which is this router here. Okay, so we're gonna call this. Didn't look like I pushed the configs there for my XR routers, so let's grab these XR1's config and then XR2's config. Drop that in real quick. That's good. Alright, so on XR1, let's go ahead and create our VRF. VPN, I believe that's B. Address family, IPv4 unicast, route import, route target 100.02, export route target 100.02. Commit. So show run VRF, and So that's good. So now on each respective router, let's go ahead on router 2, we need to assign router 1's interface to the VRF. So let's go back here. I'm going to assign router 1. So on router 1, we're going to go to interface, or router 2, actually, sorry. We're going to go to interface gig1.12, do show run interface gig1.12. And then we'll do VRF forwarding, VPN A. Add the IP address back onto the interface. So router 2 is good. We need to do the same thing for 4 and 5. So 4 is going to have VPN B going to router 7. Show IP interface brief, show run interface gig1.47. VRF forwarding, we'll call this VPN B. And then we'll re-add the IP address back on. Same thing with router 5. His is going to be router 8. His link between him and 8. Run interface gig1.58. So do VRF forwarding, VPN A. Next one's left is XR1, so we're going to XR1, and on interface 1920, show IP interface brief, 1920 is what we got to do that on. So we're going to go show run interface gig 20, and XR1, I've said this in the previous videos, but just so we reiterate to remember this, we need to always, the order of operation matters when it comes to reassigning a interface that already had an IP address on it. So you gotta remove the IP address, then add the interface, and then re-add the IP address. And show IPv4 interface brief. Show IPv4 all. Show IPv4 VRF all interface brief. And it should show me that he's in VPN B. So that's good to go. So we got the first two steps completed. Let's go ahead and pull back our instructions here. So the first two steps are done. Now we need to configure EIGRP AS1 between the PE and CEs and advertise the CEs loopbacks. So let's go ahead and let's on our CEs first. Let's go ahead and our CEs in this case is going to be router 1. 7, 8, and XR2 that we're going to need to enable EIGRP on. So we'll go ahead and do that on each router. So router 1, interface, router, EIGRP 1. No, auto summary, network, 1.1.1.1. Network 10.1.2.0. That's good. So let's just go ahead and work it out from the both sides. So router 1 and router 2. On router 2, let's get EIGRP up and going. GRP. System 1, no auto summary, topology base, no auto summary, network 10.1.2.0, and that should bring up my adjacency, perfect. So 1 and 2 is good. Let's go to 4 and 7. Just copying this. EIGRP show run section router EIGRP. thing that's gonna need to change here is the 4 and 7. And then router once config show run section .grp. We'll just take this here. .7.7.7.7.4.7. So this is gonna go on router 4. Oh, wrong VPN. This is gonna go on router 4. This we just definitely not have. So that's good. And then on router 7. This is gonna go there. Good. So 4 and 7's up. Let's do 5 and 8. So 5 has VPNA. This is gonna be 5 and 8. And this will be 8.8.8.8. And this is 5 and then 8. So let's go ahead and go to router 5 and add this config. That's good. And then on router 8, let's add his config. And we should get an adjacency up. Perfect. So we have all our adjacencies up on our XE boxes. Let's go to XR1 and XR2. So XR1, we're going to need to do a router EIGRP. CE, address family, CE, and then we're going to do VRF VPN B, address family, IPv4, no, I keep doing address family, yeah, that's right, autonomous system, actually. Autonomous system 1. Interface gig 0.1920. That's all we need there. Router, GRP core. Address family, IPv4, autonomous system, 1. And then interface gig, 220, and then interface loopback 0. And we should have an adjacency come up here. We got GRP neighbors. Let's look at it from his standpoint. Yep, and we have our neighbor up. Let's just do a quick show route. VRF VPN B. Good. So that step is done. So we went ahead and got EIGRP configured on all the CE links and CPE links. Next, we're going to configure BGP on router 2, 5, and 2, 4, 5, and then XR1. And XR1 is going to be the VPN V4 route reflector. So the config is actually going to be pretty easy on this one. So what we're going to do is just go to start on XR1, and we'll do all his BGP config here. So on XR1, show on router BGP, nothing's there. So as I get started, the first thing I'm going to do is I need to create the VRF instance for VPNB, because unlike iOS XE and XR, when you configure the route distinguisher, since the route distinguisher is actually something that BGP uses for the local BGP process uses for placing VPN routes into the correct routing table, that in iOS XR was brought into the BGP configuration, not under the VRF, unlike XE. So reason why I'm doing this first is I want to go ahead and make sure I don't forget that part. So, and this is VPNB, just family IPv4 unicast, And then I need to do an address family VPN V4 unicast. Alright, so that's good. Show one router BGP. So that's what my basic looks like. So first off is we need to create our neighbors. So we already enabled the VPN V4 AFI-SAFI in the global part of the process. So we need to go ahead and start specifying our neighbors. So the first thing is we're gonna do neighbor, and then let's see, 2, 4, 5. Okay, so we need to do 1.2.2.2, and we'll just do this one first. So remote AS is 100, update source is loopback 0, address family VPN V4 unicast, and then we're gonna call for a route reflector. He's gonna be a route reflector client, and I believe that's all I need. I'm gonna say that's all I need. So what we're gonna do here is do some shortcuts. Show one router BGP. And we're just gonna take this, and we're gonna dump this into Notepad real quick. And we're just gonna duplicate the other ones for the other part neighbors. So we had our 2, 4, and 5. So 4.4.4.4, 5.5.5.5. So is that right? 2, 4, 5. Good. So let's go ahead and add that to XR1's config. Beautiful. Let's commit that. Good to go. So now on 2, 4, and 5. Let's go ahead and create its routers, BGP, and then, actually, yep, and we're just gonna get the sessions up first. So in this case, it's gonna be, we're not gonna do templates. I usually do pure templates and all that stuff, but in this case, it's not that, it's not necessary. So 19, 19, 19, 19, because of the fact we're only doing one neighbor. Update source loopback 0, and then no BGP default update 4 unicast, and that just disables the address family for the IPv4. So I don't want that. I don't want 19 to try to negotiate that when the open message gets sent. So we're disabling IPv4, and now under address family VPN V4. Neighbor 19, 19, 19, 19, 19, activate. Wait, did I not? Show, do the show run, section router, BGP. Yes, I did do that. 19, 19, 19, 19, remote AS 100, update source, loopback 0, address family, VPN V4, neighbor 19, 19, 19, 19, activate. And normally you would have to do the send community extended, but I forgot what version of the iOS software that it automatically adds that command in there for you, so we don't really need that. So we just go ahead and section router BGP, and we're just going to take this config and just dump this right on 4 and 5. Good, and oops, and good. So 4 and 5 should come up here shortly. So 4 is good, and then we're waiting on 5. 5 is good. So we have our BGP session up. So if we look at it from router one, XR1's perspective, show BGP VPN V4 unicast, show BGP VPN V4 unicast. Hey, what the heck? Show, oh, summary, sorry. And we have all our neighbors that are up here. So let's look at the next step. So we got BGP configured. And one of the things that we didn't do is we do our redistribution between our EIGRP processes and our VPN V4 BGP process either. So let's go ahead and do that on R2. go back with the diagram here. On R2, we're going to redistribute the EIGRP1 into BGP. So, router BGP100, adjust family IPv4, VRF, VPNA, redistribute EIGRP1, and then forgot what I did with the EIGRP process, if I called it CE when I did, okay. We're gonna go to topology base, redistribute BGP 100, and then router 1 should be learning routes, show IP route. Oh, he's not yet. There's a catch to the reason why. So what I need to do is something on XR1, router BGP 100, BGP default. Where is it at? Can't believe I forgot the command here. Sender address family IPv4. Unicast. BGP. Gotta kill me. Where is it? It's not advertised. BGP. Oh man, this is gonna kill me. I cannot believe I forgot the dang command. Damn sure forgot the dang command. Show IP route VRF VPN B. No, wait. It's not exporting anything. Oh, you know why? Because he's not distributing anything out, but let me make sure this is going to work. Family IPv4 unicast IPv4 VRF VPNA redistribute EIGRP1 router EIGRPCE address family IPv4 VRF VPNA autonomous system 1 topology base, redistribute BGP 100. Okay, not worked. I think that's right. So in iOS XR, it does the route target filtering automatically. There is a command under iOS XR that allows you to disable or enable the ability to filter out route targets for VPN V4. Due to the fact that if the VRF is not configured on the box itself, it won't actually import the route targets. But with the route reflection command, I think in iOS XR, that's what's enabling it to do that by default. But in iOS XE, that's not there. So I was thinking I needed to do that, but I don't. So we'll just keep moving forward. So on router 4, let's do the same thing. Router BGP 100, address family, IPv4, VRF, VPN-B, redistribute EIGRP-1, router EIGRP-CE, address family, IPv4, VRF, VPN-B, Autonomous system one, topology base, and now we're going to redistribute BGP 100. So now, on XR1, we need to do the same thing. Router BGP 100, VRF VPN B, adjust family IPv4 unicast, redistribute EIGRP 1, and then same thing on router, show run router EIGRP, router EIGRP CE, adjust family IPv4, redistribute BGP 100. Alright, and commit. So XR2 should be learning 7 routes. Oh boy, here we go again. Let's see. This wasn't a bug. I did this in the last video with this EIGRP between XR show route. And it should be VPNB. EIGRP. That's the reason why I put it in the wrong place. Alright, so let's do this. No on that. Alright, and then we're going under the adjust family and we need to do a redistribute BGP 100. Commit. Alright, any second now, once this clears up. Perfect. Okay, so in the last step is to, once complete, R1 should have reachability to all R8 networks and vice versa. And XR2 should have reachability to R7's network. And all we're going to do is just do a ping on each router. So I'm going to ping R7's loopback address and source it for my own. And that should show me reachability there. Perfect. And then on R1, I should be able to ping router 8, and then I source it from loopback 0. The XR configuration is a little bit easier, I think, as far as the route reflection it goes, because of the fact that if you look at the way that they do the neighbor statements, it just makes sense of how it groups up the neighbors, and then you have all the attributes under the neighbors. But then, like I said, normally under the VPN V4, I'll show you what it looks like in iOS XE. The command that I'm talking about is the no BGP default route target filter. Now, there is an equivalent command on iOS XR. I just can't remember it off of the top of the head. But this is what you would have to do on XE to get your route reflector that is not participating in VPN V4. To start accepting and reflecting routes out. But XR, it does it by default, and I think because of the fact that when you initiate the route reflector command, the route reflector client command on the neighbors, it disables that feature on the back end. So there is a catch, like I said, to iOS XR and XE that you got to be aware of. So that was that. The next one is going to be sham links, which is one of my probably favorite topics. I'll actually do a little demonstration about, I'll go into what sham links are first and then go into the lab if you guys are already familiar with sham links are. But I'll go ahead and put a check on that, and I'll see you in the next video for the next tutorial. All right, later.